Good morning, everyone. So today we are going to start with our second topic, that is units and measurement. So our second topic is units and measurement. In this second topic, first we will see what are the contents of this lesson. What are the contents of this lesson? So this chapter, it is totally for 4 marks. You will get 2 marks one question and you will get 1+1. So 3 to 4 marks will be there from this chapter. It is one of the important chapter, because here you are going to deal with the basic concepts, how measurements are done. You are using units. For example, mass, if you measure, if you go to shop, you will say 10 kg of sugar, 5 kg of rice. How you will measure the time? So time you will measure in terms of seconds. Length, area of the room, these all measurements, how you are going to use the units, that we will see in this lesson. That is your units and measurement. This is the second topic of physics. Out of 15 chapters, this is the second topic, units and measurement. So in this units and measurement, the contents are, so 3 to 4 marks will be there for your annual exam. Okay, so contents of this lesson are, first concept you are going to learn, what do you mean by physical quantity? First you are going to learn, what do you mean by physical quantity? Then second, after physical quantity, you are going to learn types of physical quantity. Types of physical quantity. Then the third point you are going to learn, third point you have, that is introduction to units, or you can just say units and its types. Units and its types. So this is third point. Then the fourth point you are going to see, that is measurement of length, mass, time. Measurement of length, mass and time. Then after that you have accuracy, precision and errors. So accuracy, precision and errors, these are the next point. Then next point we are going to discuss, I hope here it is visible. So next you are going to see significant figures. Then last concept is dimensions. So this dimensions, it is the important point in this lesson. That is dimensions, dimension formula we have, dimension analysis we have, dimension equations we have. So last concept is very, very important. These are basic concepts. First, whatever you are learning, no? These are basic concepts. I think yesterday I gave you some work. What was that? I told you to see conservation something. I gave you some work, no? What was that? Isolated system. What do you mean by isolated system? I asked you to search. What do you mean by isolated system? Example for unification. Yes, correct. Okay. See, you people did not inform me in the beginning of the class. Okay, tell me someone, what do you mean by isolated system? Very simple definition. What do you mean by isolated system? Physical system so far removed from the other systems. Any other answer? You can unmute yourself and you can tell me. A thermodynamic system enclosed by rigid involvement walls, which either pass more energy. Okay. Solitum system is a single object that doesn't interact with any other objects. An isolated system has consistently changing energy. Okay. So here isolated system in the sense, it is a system which consists of large number of particles. It is a system which consists of either large number of particles, or you can take one or two particles also. It is a system which consists of large number of particles where there is no external force acts on the body. Now, I am standing in this room. Which force is acting on me? Gravitational force is acting on me, and the upward force, that is normal force, is acting on me, right? If you keep one book on the table, again the gravitational force and the normal force is acting on it. Means here, on all the objects in this universe, the forces are acting. You agree with this concept, correct? Because you have already studied force, correct? जो भी ऑब्जेक्ट यूनिवर्स में है उसके ऊपर फोर्स एक्ट होता है. वन और द अदर फोर्स विल बी एक्टिंग. आइसोलेटेड सिस्टम इज सच अ सिस्टम. फॉर एग्जांपल यू कैन टेक दिस चॉक बॉक्स. आई विल से दिस एज अ आइसोलेटेड सिस्टम. एग्जांपल है, जस्ट एग्जांपल. मतलब इसके अंदर जो पार्टिकल्स है, व्हाट आर देयर? चॉक्स आर देयर. सो व्हाट एवर द पार्टिकल्स आर देयर विद इन दिस बॉक्स, देयर इज नो एनी एक्सटर्नल फोर्स एक्ट ऑन दैट पार्टिकल. So such a closed system or such a system is known as what? Isolated system. Such a system is known as what? Isolated system. Understood with the example? Means suppose this, if you consider this chalk box, if you consider it as isolated system, it consists of what? Large number of particles where there is no external forces acting on a body. Such a system is called as what? Isolated system. You have to create such a system. But if you take in the nature, on all the system, one or the other forces are acting on it, right? This is regarding isolated system. And unification, any other examples you people have searched? I gave you regarding Newton, Oersted and Faraday, electricity. But who gave that unification? That is electromagnetic theory only, no? Faraday and Oersted will give that electromagnetic theory. Okay, today that work will that homework will continue. You are going to search unification of physical laws, some other examples. Unification of physical laws, some other examples. Okay, so we will come for the today's point. That is, our second topic is units and measurement, which consist of 3 to 4 marks in your annual examination. Then next, we have contents of this chapter. Physical quantity. What do you mean by physical quantity? Types of physical quantity, units and its types, measurement of length, mass, time, accuracy, precision, error. मतलब इस तीनों का meaning देखने वाले हो. What do you mean by accuracy? What do you mean by precision? What do you mean by errors? So next we have significant figures, which you will study in chemistry also. In chemistry you have detailed study about this. Significant figure. Then next you have dimensions, which is the important part in this lesson. So I hope the contents are clear to you. So first we'll proceed with the first point, that is physical quantity. We have the first term here, that is physical quantity. Concentrate in this lesson very nicely, because your practicals, I hope you know that your question paper is of 70 marks. You know this one, no? I don't remember. In first class I told you, or no, I don't remember. You will be having 70 marks theory paper. Physics, biology and chemistry, same. And mathematics will be 100 marks paper. So physics, biology and chemistry, 70 marks paper will be there, theory paper. Then 30 marks you will be having practicals. 30 marks you will be having practicals. 30 marks practicals matlab kya? Ek hi experiment karte ho usme. In physics at least, you will be doing only one experiment. This 30 marks we will divide. This 30 marks we will divide it. CS also same. Bio and CS same. That is 70 marks and 30 marks practicals. Okay. So 30 marks, whatever practicals will be there, there we have in this 34 marks. Matlab 26 marks writing mein rehta hai wo. Your practicals, kaise karte ho, that all. 4 marks, we will be asking you some questions, oral questions. Aap school mein oral question answers karte ho na? Oral questions will be asked. So that questions will be from this lesson in physics. That is units and measurement. This is the basic concept. So concentrate properly. Okay. So I hope you understood the importance of this lesson. So 70 marks theory, 30 marks practical, same pattern will be there. The 70 marks, 1 mark questions, 2 marks questions, 3 marks questions and 5 marks questions. When you will be having midterm exam, we will discuss that time. Or unit test rehta na, tabhi discuss karenge ye sabhi. Okay, we will come for our topic. So the first concept you are going to study here, that is physical quantity. So what do you mean by physical quantity? Very simple definition. The quantities. Quantities matlab pata chalta hai na, quantities like mass, weight, force, acceleration, speed. Ye sabhi hum kya bolte hai? Quantities. These are physical quantities. The quantities which can be measured. The quantities which can be measured and expressed directly or indirectly. I'll write the definition. The quantity or the quantities which can be measured and expressed directly or indirectly. Such a quantities are called as what? Physical quantities. The quantities which can be measured and expressed directly or indirectly, it is called as physical quantity. Now you will ask me, what is the meaning of this? Okay, if you read textbook, you will read this. But what is the meaning of this statement here? The quantities which can be measured. Measured in the sense, for example, if I want to measure the area of this box. How you will measure the area of this box? You will measure this area of the box as length into breadth. Is the formula correct? How you measure the length area here? Length into breadth is the formula to measure the area of this chalk box. Correct? Hai? So that is what measurement and expressing. How you will express? For example, if you are measuring the area. Area kaise measure kar rahe ho? Area you are measuring it as length into breadth. So after measuring length and breadth, you will say, suppose if it is 5 into 2, it is how much it is? It is 10 meter square. You are expressing it. You are expressing area into area as what? Meter square. 10 meter square. Usko kaise measure kar rahe ho? 10 meter square karke measure kar rahe ho. So the quantity which can be measured and expressed directly or indirectly. So you measured it by using length into breadth formula, that is, and expressed it in terms of meter square. So such quantities are called as what? Physical quantities. We have area. Then next I will measure length. Length how you will measure? You will take a meter scale. You have a scale. Take that meter scale. You can measure the length. Correct? Then mass measurement. You can measure mass of a body. Weight of a body. If you have a weighing machine, you can measure the weight of a body. So these all quantities we call it as what? Physical quantity. Aap puchoge abhi isme kya badi baat hai? Here, there are some quantities which cannot be measured, which cannot be expressed, which cannot be measured and which cannot be expressed. For example, how much you love your parents? Can you measure this one? Is it possible to measure how much you love your parents, your sisters, your brothers? How much you fight with them? Is it possible to measure these all things? No, you cannot measure such things. Happiness. Today you are happy. Can you tell me how much you are happy? You can just compare that. You are happy today compared to yesterday. You are more happy today. You can just say more happy, less happy. You cannot measure it as 10, 20. Aise measure nahi kar sakte ho usko. Correct? So, the quantities. The quantities which can be measured, area measure kar sakte ho, length measure kar sakte ho, height, weight, force, acceleration, speed, then pressure, stress, मोमेंटम यू कैन टेक एनी क्वांटिटीज, मतलब फिजिक्स में जो भी वर्ड्स यूज करते हो ना, दैट ऑल क्वांटिटीज वी कॉल इट एज व्हाट, फिजिकल क्वांटिटी. हाउ मच यू आर हैप्पी, हाउ मच यू आर सैड, हाउ मच यू लव योर पेरेंट्स, दीज ऑल क्वांटिटीज यू कैन नॉट एक्सप्रेस एज वेल एज यू कैन नॉट मेजर इट. सो सच क्वांटिटीज आर कॉल्ड एज नॉन फिजिकल क्वांटिटी. इसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? फिजिकल क्वांटिटी. आई होप द फिजिकल क्वांटिटी मीनिंग इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन. द क्वांटिटीज विच कैन बी मेजर्ड एंड एक्सप्रेस्ड डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली, आई एम सेइंग. सो नाउ वी विल सी, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय डायरेक्टली, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय इनडायरेक्टली. डायरेक्टली मतलब क्या? अभी लेंथ मेजर करने के लिए क्या करते हो आप लोग? यू विल जस्ट टेक स्केल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, सेम चॉक बॉक्स का लेंथ चाहिए हमें. यू विल जस्ट प्लेस योर स्केल हियर. यू विल जस्ट रीड वॉट एवर द रीडिंग इज देर. उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? डायरेक्ट मेजरमेंट बोलते हैं. एरिया कैसे कैलकुलेट कर रहे हो? देखो, टू कैलकुलेट एरिया यू वॉन्ट लेंथ, यू वॉन्ट ब्रेड्थ. दो क्वांटिटीज मेजर करके आपको एरिया मिल रहा है. इसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? इनडायरेक्ट मेथड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मेजर फोर्स, फोर्स को कैसे मेजर करते हो बोलो? फोर्स इज इक्वल टू न्यूटन्स फॉर्मूला. व्हाट इज फोर्स इज इक्वल टू? इट इज रेनिंग, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट देर मे बी सम नेटवर्क इश्यू. ओके, फोर्स कैसे मेजर करते हो? फोर्स इज इक्वल टू एम इनटू ए. दिस इज इनडायरेक्ट मेथड, करेक्ट? So, direct method, indirect method. Understood? What is the meaning of direct method and indirect method? Direct matlab directly by using some instrument you will measure. Speed kaise measure karte ho? Speedometer se measure karte ho. Either you can say it as direct method or you can say it as indirect method. Directly instrument se measure karne ko aata hai to usko direct method. If you are using formula, force is measured in terms of mass into acceleration. Area length into breadth, pressure thrust divided by area. ऐसे formula use करके indirectly if you are measuring, means if it consists of two or more physical quantities, उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? Indirect method. I hope the idea of physical quantity is clear to everyone. The quantities which can be measured and expressed directly or indirectly is known as physical quantity. Is it clear? Shall I go for the next point? ओके, सो नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज, दिस चैप्टर कंसिस्ट ऑफ मेनी डेफिनेशंस. नेक्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस मेजरमेंट. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज मेजरमेंट. सो मेजरमेंट मीन्स हियर how you measure, what do you mean by measurement? So what you can say, the definition of measurement here, it is a comparison. I'll write the definition, then I'll try to explain you. So here, it is a comparison of a physical quantity with another quantity of same kind taken as standard. So definition is complicated, but if you understand it, you can write it in your own words. Okay. So what do you mean by measurement here? Measurement. In day-to-day life, you use this term measurement. That is, for example, if you want to construct a home, they will do measurement, correct? They will measure whatever the area is there. The measurement will be done to construct different rooms. Different measurements will be there. So in day-to-day life, you use this term. Measurement of area, measurement of mass. If you want to stitch the uniform or if you want to stitch any clothes, you will give measurement. Measurement, what is the meaning of this measurement? Have you ever thought of it? No. Then here, what do you mean by measurement? That we are going to discuss today. So, measurement here, it is nothing but it is the measuring of physical quantities. Either it may be mass, it may be length, it may be time, it may be density, स्पीड फोर्स एनीथिंग सो मेजरमेंट सो हियर इन ऑल द फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज वी से मेजरमेंट व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय मेजरमेंट हियर मेजरमेंट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन अवर डे टू डे लाइफ फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू गो टू एनी शॉप इफ यू वॉन्ट टू बाय एनी वेजिटेबल If you just tell them you want this, whatever that XYZ vegetable is there or XYZ some stuffs you are getting. If you just say you want that XYZ item, you have to say the measurement. They will ask you how much you want. That is nothing but what? Measurement here. Then what is the exact physics definition for measurement that we have here? Measurement, it is a comparison of a physical quantity it is a comparison of a physical quantity with another quantity of same kind which is taken as standard you will not understand anything by this step statement that I know I'll give you example that is mass of rice is equal to 10 kg this is one example now compare your definition with the example see it is a comparison I am comparing of a physical quantity which physical quantity I have taken mass here I'll write it full otherwise you people will get confused okay it is a comparison of a physical quantity with another quantity of same kind with another quantity of same kind which is taken as standard which is taken as standard in the sense to measure mass you always use kg kg bolte ho grams bolte ho right milligrams so here always you prefer some standard if you go and tell that is 10 seconds what is the 10 seconds measurement of time if I specify 10 kg it is measurement of mass so this is only nothing but what measurement here If I say 10 meter, 10 meter मतलब क्या है बोलो लेंथ का मेजरमेंट कर रहे हो उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं लेंथ मेजरमेंट इफ आई से 10 मीटर स्क्वायर एरिया मेजरमेंट मीन्स वेन यू कंपेयर स्टैंडर्ड इज व्हाट केजी मीटर मीटर स्क्वायर सेकेंड्स न्यूटन दीज आर ऑल व्हाट स्टैंडर्ड्स दीज आर ऑल व्हाट स्टैंडर्ड्स यू आर कंपेयरिंग योर फिजिकल क्वांटिटी The standard ones that is called as what measurement. Measurement मतलब क्या है comparison है क्या क्या compare कर रहे हो You are comparing a given physical quantity कौन सा भी रहे वो mass भी रह सकता है length, area, time, density, speed, acceleration, velocity, weight, momentum कुछ भी रह सकता है कुछ भी Here, comparison of a given physical quantity with the same kind which is taken as standard one. Which is taken as standard one. If you say kg, it will specify mass. Standard is kya hai? Kg is standard one. You are comparing with mass. Seconds, if you are telling, you are measuring the time. If you say 10 newton, kya measure kar rahe ho bolo? If I say 10 newton. What you are measuring? What is measurement? Newton किसको बोलते हो? Force. Force, correct? So here, if I that is standard reference. Are you getting? I hope you are understanding. If you are not understanding, you can ask me once again. I'll repeat it. So here, measurement is nothing but. कंपैरिजन पहले ये याद रखो कि मेजरमेंट मतलब क्या है इट इज अ कंपैरिजन क्या कंपेयर कर रहे हो गिवन फिजिकल क्वांटिटी विथ सेम काइंड विच इज टेकन एज स्टैंडर्ड स्टैंडर्ड क्यों बोलते हो बोलो इफ यू गो टू शॉप इफ यू से केजी दे विल मेजर मास ओनली इफ यू से लीटर देन व्हाट दे विल मेजर So liter is also mass measurement. You can take milk, oil, that all we measure in terms of liters here. Correct hai? So here that measurement is standard one. Second bole to kya? Wo time hi rehta hai. So second we are not using for any other quantity. Correct? Newton, we measure force. Right? Joules, you will say joule. What is that joule? It is the unit of work. Work is a physical quantity. So that is measurement. Correct? Meter, length measurement. Correct? It is a comparison. You are comparing. One more example I'll write for your understanding. Work is equal to, I'll say 15 joules. I am comparing comparison of a given physical quantity with a same kind which is taken as standard. This is called as what? Measurement. Any doubt here? If you concentrate properly, then you will understand. You want me to repeat once again or you understood? Read the definition. Definition maine isliye bold pe likha hai, dekho. Definitions padho. And compare the example. Samajh mein aata hai. Simple. All 51 students, I hope, clear to everyone. Okay. Just remember three key terms here. That is comparison matlab kya hai? Sorry, measurement matlab kya hai? It is a comparison. Comparison between what? Between a given physical quantity and the standard one. That much. So three key terms yaad rakho, definitions apne aap likh sakte ho. Done? Okay. So if these two definitions are clear to you, that is physical quantity and measurement, we will go for the next definition, that is unit. Unit. What do you mean by unit? Now, just now I said 10 kg, 5 seconds, 15 joules, 10 newton. So, newton, joules, seconds, kg, gram, these are all what? Unit. These are all what? Units here. Then, what do you mean by unit? Till today, you have used many units. You have used many units because in school, you people have studied, no? Speed is measured in terms of. Yaad hai aap logo ko speed kaise measure karte ho? What is the unit of speed? Do you remember? Unit of speed. Vega in Kannada. How you measure speed? Kilometer per hour. Okay. You can take kilometer per hour. Distance upon time, it is a formula. Yes, you people don't know the difference between formula and unit. So only we have this lesson, units and measurement. Speed is measured in terms of distance divided by time. This distance divided by time, what I am writing, it is a formula. It is measured in terms of, you people are telling me it is kilometer per hour. Okay, this is correct. Okay. We have one more unit, that is meter per second. अभी इसमें correct कौन सा है? वो अभी इसमें पढ़ना है हमें. Kilometer per hour भी बोलते हो, meter per second भी बोलते हो. Then which is correct here? That we are going to concentrate in this part, that is units. So first we will see what is unit. First you understand unit कौन से किसको बोलते हैं? किसको unit बोलते हैं? Kilometer, meter, kilometer per hour, meter per second. So then kg, grams, इसको हम unit बोलते हैं. Here what I have written, इसको formula बोलते हैं. वो पहले याद रखो. Please remember this clearly, right? Okay. So first again I'll write the definition, then I'll explain. Units. So how you are going to define unit? Unit is nothing but it is a standard reference, internationally accepted. Internationally accepted. Reference standard to measure the physical quantity. This is your definition of what? Unit here. What do you mean by unit? Unit is nothing but internationally accepted. accepted means throughout the world it should be correct. In India or in Belgium, if you are measuring time in terms of seconds, outside also you are measuring with seconds only. Correct. So suppose here if you are measuring in terms of kg, so kg only we are using, means internationally accepted. But money, how you measure? That is, in India we have rupees, currency. That is, we have here we have, that is rupees. In different countries we have different currencies, right? So if you take Dubai and all, there you have, I think, real is there. Then other countries, you know, any other countries, dollar is there. In America, USA, we use dollar. Correct. Okay, we don't have that concept, let it be. Euros. छोड़ो उसको छोड़ो, ये हमारा यूनिट देखेंगे. वी डोंट हैव करेंसी कॉन्सेप्ट, वी आर नॉट कॉमर्स स्टूडेंट्स टू डील विद करेंसी. सो हियर यूनिट इज नथिंग बट इट इज इंटरनेशनली एक्सेप्टेड, मीन्स एवरीवेयर इट इज एक्सेप्टेड. वो करेक्ट रहना चाहिए. रेफरेंस स्टैंडर्ड टू मेजर द फिजिकल क्वांटिटी. इट इज जस्ट अ रेफरेंस टू मेजर फिजिकल क्वांटिटी, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज यूनिट. It is just a reference to measure a physical quantity, that is called as unit. Means kg is just a reference to measure what? Mass. Meter or kilometer, it is just a reference to measure what? Distance, or you can take length. Then seconds, it is just a reference which is accepted through internationally to measure time. Newton, it is a reference to measure force. Then you can take Pascal. Pascal kiska unit hai bolo? Pascal, which unit it is? Where we use Pascal? Don't remember. Sab bhul gaya dekho school ka. That is, pressure is measured in terms of Pascal. So that is what? Just a reference, internationally accepted reference standard to measure the physical quantity. Simple. That is called as what? Unit here. Internationally accepted reference standard to measure the physical quantity is known as a unit here. So in units we have two types, that is fundamental units and derived units. We have two types, that is fundamental unit and derived unit. And always units consist of two parts. Always unit consist of two parts here. So which are those two parts? What do you mean by fundamental quantity, fundamental units, and what do you mean by derived units? That we will discuss in the next class. So till now, any doubt you have? This chapter you have many definitions, so full concentration should be there. Kuch doubt hai isme? Physical quantity matlab kya? What do you mean by physical quantity? What do you mean by measurement? What do you mean by unit? Today I took this class very slowly. Okay. So tomorrow I'll send notes. Matlab at least ek page to hota hai wo. So tomorrow I'll send you notes of this. Aaj bheja to sirf three definitions will be there. Tomorrow I'll send. Okay. Tomorrow your work is unification ka ye thoda dhoondo. Current unit mein hai kya? Current ampere. Current is ampere. That is also a physical quantity measured in terms of ampere.